In 2011, MSF decided to open a trauma hospital in the northern Afghan city of Kunduz to provide high-quality, free surgical care to victims of all types of trauma. In that region, before the opening of Kunduz, severely injured people were forced to make long and dangerous journeys to the capital, Kabul, or Pakistan to receive the care they needed. MSF teams converted shipping containers into a functional hospital equipped with 55 beds, an emergency room, two operating theatres, an intensive care unit, as well as X-ray and laboratory facilities. The hospital was busy from the outset. Even during the first months, it was often full. Most patients were Kunduz locals, but word spread about the free and high-quality care provided. People started coming from neighbouring provinces like Tahar and Bahlan, or even from Faizabad and Mazar-e-Sharif. The MSF teams treated everyone, civilians, combatants, and people from all ethnic groups. And just like in all MSF hospitals, a strict no-weapons policy was put in place.
Tell him he has a big fracture of the skull. The skull was cracked like this, and he's very lucky to even be alive.
Most patients were victims of traffic or domestic accidents, but bomb blasts and violent protests also brought waves of wounded people. The medical team had to learn how to quickly identify who was in most need of critical care. Starting in 2012, massive construction work transformed the old Spinza building into a 92-bed, high-level trauma hospital. In 2013, medical teams soon began to perform complex internal fixation procedures. The combination of the expansion plus the need to maintain a high quality of care meant lots of recruitment and lots of training. In only a few years, the hospital had become a lifeline for people in Kunduz and the surrounding provinces. But in January 2014, the entire medical stock of the hospital was destroyed in a fire. Medicines and supplies were ruined, and construction plans put on hold. Despite this setback, the medical team continued to focus on improving internal fixation procedures and care for patients with severe head trauma. Physiotherapy and mental health services were also expanded. 2015 saw the heaviest fighting season in Kunduz for many years. Hundreds of war-wounded patients were treated at the hospital in May and June.
Non sei tu direttamente l'obiettivo, ma ne rimani coinvolto e sono sempre civili a restarne coinvolti.
Reaching the hospital became more and more difficult for people from outside Kunduz city. A normally short journey could take hours. People had to cross multiple checkpoints, risking landmines and crossfire to get the care they needed. One district, Chardara, was particularly isolated. At the end of June, MSF opened a district advance post there, so severely injured patients were able to be stabilized before they could be transported to Kunduz city. On the 1st of July, Afghan special forces carried out a violent armed intrusion into the hospital. They harassed patients and physically assaulted staff. MSF condemned this unacceptable breach of international humanitarian law. The hospital closed its doors for 5 days, whilst MSF engaged with the military authorities to emphasize the neutrality and protection of medical facilities to make sure that such an incident would not happen again. On the 28th of September 2015, the MSF hospital suddenly found itself in the middle of a quickly shifting front line. The armed opposition launched a takeover of Kunduz city. The team was overwhelmed with hundreds of wounded patients. They urgently increased the capacity of the hospital to 130 beds.
There's gas here.
MSF staff risked their lives to ensure the hospital kept running. they managed to perform 138 surgeries and treat 376 patients in just 5 days. At that time, the Kunduz Trauma Center became the last sanctuary for the wounded amidst the fighting. Men, women, children, civilians, and combatants from both sides were all cared for with dignity. The no weapons policy was strictly respected by everyone. Starting at 2:08 a.m. on Saturday, the 3rd of October, a United States AC-130 gunship fired 211 shells on the main hospital building where patients were sleeping in their beds or being operated on in the operating theatre. Our surviving staff set up a makeshift operating table in the hospital kitchen to try and save their wounded friends and colleagues. Worldwide, the public joined the MSF movement in expressing outrage and calling for an independent investigation into the attack.
We ask you to sign our petition, Independent Investigation Kunduz. We claim the protection and respect of humanitarian medical action to victims of war close to the front line.
Fourteen of our colleagues, 24 of our patients, and 4 of their caretakers were killed in the attack. 37 people were injured, some of them left with lifelong problems. Thousands of people were left without life-saving medical care.